Here we are in 8 things no kids should leave home without, which is not just for parents, it's also for businessmen and women. We're talking about communication skills on the job. If you're ever going to get promoted, if you're ever going to get noticed, you better watch what you say, okay? Now, we've covered this in relationships as far as husband and wife, but on the workplace, it's even more critical. People don't want to hear what you think. They want to know if you can solve a problem. You know, life and death in the power of the tongue. So if I open my mouth at work, I'm trying to solve something, fix something, not accuse somebody. Well, that idiot tore it up and that person left that way. No. My job, like Jesus, I'm to leave everything in every position better than I find it. Because I don't care what you think. People will notice. You don't have to defend yourself all the time. And one of the things you'll notice is when you're in the locker room or you're punching in or you're in a break room, you're going to lunch, it's a business lunch, guard your mouth. Don't just let anything hit your brain roll out of your mouth. You know, there's some things I can talk about just with family. That's what it is. Things between me and my wife, between me and my wife. I don't share at work. Hey, you know what my wife did the other day? You know what my wife said the other day? Because you might as well strike a match to a gasoline lake because it's going to get back to her. There's some things you just guard. Same things at work. Things I share with my boss, the plant manager. If we ever get called in, I had a meeting, or my pastor, if I was on staff. What happens in that office between me and him stays there. That is not free privilege information. Hey, you know what Pastor and I were talking about? Hey, you know what plant manager and I were talking? No, that's private information. So the first thing about being successful in business, you got to learn to control your mouth. What can you say? What can you not say? I'm not a billboard from hell on the side of the interstate. Just because I heard it doesn't mean I can repeat it. So if you'll just take your Bible and go to the book of Proverbs, read one proverb a day for a month, highlight all the scriptures about the mouth and the tongue, I'll promise you, you'll get a promotion. You're going to raise. People will realize I can trust them. I share some of them. They don't just strike a match to a gasoline lake. I can trust what I share, what I say. Now, I remember when I was on staff at church, there were things I had to do. People would come sometimes to Mr. McGee or Joe, can I tell you, if I tell you something, can you keep a secret? Now, in that position, I had to say, no, I cannot. I'm bound by state laws what I can and can't share. You share something with me about child abuse or something illegal, I'm bound by law to report that. I love you. I want to help you. I'm trying to restore you. But no, not everything can be a secret. Not everything can be a secret. And so you have to know up front what you can and cannot say when you're talking about communication skills at work. Now, the biggest thing at work is realizing what I am talking about. If I see something wrong, I'm going to bring it up in a very professional manner. There were things I'd bring to my boss. Hey, we've got this problem, but I got 3 solutions. I always had 3 solutions. We got this problem. I think we can do this, this, and this. Sometimes I say, no. I'll get back with you tomorrow. Come back today. I got 2 other suggestions, this and this. Yes, that'll work. So what I was doing is he says yes or no. My job is to bring him the solution. And boy, they'll love you if you know how to communicate like that. It will get you a raise, I promise you.